Dear students, welcome to this video lecture based on one of the poems prescribed for BCom final year semester 5. The title of the poem is the first line of the poem itself. The title is "It is needless to ask of a saint" by Saint Kabir. Saint Kabir is well known in India as a poet, and basically he was a mystic poet. We will see what is mean by mysticism later on. First, let's see the biography of the poet Saint Kabir. Saint Kabir is a very old poet, and we come to know about him by an author. He is a Vaishnav author, Nabha Das. He wrote a book, Bhakt Mal is the title of the book, written by Nabha Das. He is one of the Vaishnav authors. Vaishnav poetry is religious poetry, so Nabha Das in that way belongs to that trend of poetry, which is called Vaishnav poetry, that is religious poetry. He wrote a book, Bhakta Mal, published in 1585. In the book he writes, Kabir lived perhaps during 1398 to 1448. So he belongs to 14th century, and the first four decades of 15th century. Kabir is thought to have lived longer than 100 years. He had enormous influence on Indian philosophy and on Hindi poetry. So Kabir and his poetry is very important part of Hindi literature. His birth and death are surrounded by legends. He grew up in a Muslim weaver family, but some say he was a son of Brahmin widow who was adopted by a childless couple. When Kabir died, his Hindu and Muslim followers started fighting about the last rites, the way last rites should be performed. The legend is that when they lifted the cloth, the shroud covering the dead body of Saint Kabir, they found only flowers there, a heap of flowers there, and the Muslim followers buried half of the flowers and the Hindu followers cremated half of the flowers. And in Magar, his tomb was erected and Samadhi was also constructed side by side. So religion is not important for Saint Kabir. He stands for humanism, humanity. His poetry was sung in the form of couplets and short verses in the local dialects. The poetry which is written by Saint Kabir is not in Hindi actually. It was local dialect which is close to Hindi. Therefore, the poems and the couplets composed by Saint Kabir is part of Hindi literature, and his poems, many poems are translated into all the Indian languages as well as in English. So he touched themes such as religion is very important factor in India, this theme is related to mysticism, love and casteism. Casteism is prevalent in Indian society today as well. We find casteism in Indian society, in some part of Indian society. We are well educated now and living in 21st century, but then also in some parts of India, casteism is practiced. Therefore, the poems of Saint Kabir are very relevant to Indian problems, because even though we are in 21st century, we are leading life in 21st century, but the social problems which we are facing today, they are there in those days also, in the days of Sant Kabir also. So therefore his poems are very relevant today as well. His poetry was transmitted to the young generation orally through popular folk music and culture. So the poems of Saint Kabir, some selected poems, Songs of Kabir, the title of collection of the poems, it was published in 1915, and this collection of poems of Saint Kabir was translated by Rabindranath Tagore and published in 1915. So here you will see you can see in the picture the first the cover page of the collection of the songs of Saint Kabir. It was translated by Rabindranath Tagore. You know, Rabindranath Tagore is also a great poet. He is the only man of literature from India who has got Nobel Prize for Literature in 1913. In the poems of Saint Kabir, we find criticism against caste system in India, and he wonders, if everyone's purpose in life is to seek God, then why do we differentiate the people on the basis of caste? This is the question. He concludes the aim of life as to find out the right path to reach to the God. If everyone is struggling to find out the right path to reach to the God, then why do we differentiate people based on caste? This was his question to the society. In other words, he means to say that all are equal. We should not differentiate people based on caste to which he or she belongs. Let's see first what is mysticism. Mysticism, Kabir is a mystic poet. So therefore we have to understand what is mysticism. These are the quotes I have taken from Wikipedia. We'll try to read and understand what is mysticism. Mysticism is known as becoming one with God or the absolute. God or absolute, one and the same. To find out way to reach to God, or to become one with God. And when the mystic poets, all the saints, in Maharashtra we find many saints like Tukaram Maharaj or Jnaneshwar, and other so many saints are there. These all saints are mystic in their philosophy, and whatever they have composed, we find mysticism ruling or dominant in their poems. So mysticism means, you know, actually becoming one with God. How one can become one with God? By following humanity, by by keeping oneself away from the this materialistic way of life, leading spiritual life, and thinking of thinking of, you know, giving everyone his own rights, and thinking that which is based on all the people are equal. And the ultimate aim of life is to reach to God. This is what mysticism is. It may also refer to attainment of insight in ultimate or hidden truths. And these mystic poets try to find out answers to some universal questions, just like, you know, what happens after death, is there any life after death, or such questions they try to find out answer to, which no one can give a satisfactory answer. And these mystic poets, they lead a different life than the common people. The term mysticism has ancient Greek origin with various historical determined meanings. It is derived from Greek word, the word is given here. It means to close or to conceal. Mysticism referred to the biblical, spiritual and contemplative dimension of early and medieval Christianity. During the early modern period, the definition of mysticism grew to include a broad range of belief and ideologies related to extraordinary experiences and states of mind. So, the experiences of mystic poets are different from the experiences of common people and the thinking of common people. So this is what mysticism is. So this is the first stanza of the poem. The stanza of the poem is like this. It is needless to ask of a saint the caste to which he belongs. For the priest, the warrior, the tradesman, and all the 36 castes alike are seeking for God. So to understand this stanza, we have to keep this stanza in the context, in a particular context of Indian society, where casteism is followed. We came to know that Saint Kabir is very important figure in Indian society, because now and then we find the dohas. Doha means couplet, two lines of a poem. These dohas of Saint Kabir are quite famous, and they are now and then quoted by the people. Through his dohas and short poems, he tried to enlighten the reformation process in the Indian society in the positive way. What is reformation? Reformation means reforming the society, bringing change in the society. So why people, mystic poets like Saint Kabir, wants to reform the Indian society? Because there is some problem in the system of Indian society, and the problem is casteism. Caste system is blot on humanity. Due to casteism, our country, India, has lost much more things. In this poem, the poet criticizes the mentality and practice of casteism or caste system in India. Dominant classes always keep attention for the development and growth of the established social system, because it preserves their ideology. What is the ideology of dominant classes of Indian society? The ideology is based on casteism, because they get lots of benefit from the system, caste system, and by using caste system they can rule in the society. Therefore they want to perpetuate caste system in the society. And when we think of a society should comprise comprise civilized groups of the people, and there should be equality in the society, then only the society develops. But unfortunately, in our country we lack the spirit of integrated society. On the other hand, due to casteism, our society divides the people into fragments of different castes, religion, and sometimes we also face regionalism in our country. So due to these problems, we will not be able to become a powerful society or a powerful country. If the people are treated equally in the society, then only the society will progress. On the other hand, if we practice social discrimination and political separation, economic disparity, then we will not be able to become a developed our country will not become a developed nation. And we are now in 21st century. 21st century is the century of human rights, which always fight for the basic fundamental rights of human beings, and everybody should get freedom. So therefore it is very important for us to establish a just society, a society where everyone gets equal rights. And in those days, the aim of life was to find out right path to reach to God. Therefore the poet says that if everyone wants to reach to God, if everyone's aim of life is to find out the right path to reach to God, then we should not distinguish. And here the poet also gives the profession of different castes. The high caste people are priests or warriors, and the lower caste people are tradesmen. Tradesmen like they do different kinds of trade, and the lowest, the oppressed caste, the lowest caste is also there. These people who belong to the lowest caste, they serve the people who belong to the caste such as their profession, such as tradesman or priest. So, and 36 castes are there in Indian society, the poet says. So these, we should stop this casteism, what the poet urges us in this stanza, in the first stanza of the poem. So after the first stanza, explanation of the first stanza, let's understand what is meant by couplet. So I told you that Kabir writes dohas. His dohas are quite famous. One of the doha I want to introduce you is, the lines are actually written in local language, but this local language is very close to Hindi. Kal kare so aaj kar, आज करे सो अब, पल में प्रलय होएगी, बाहुरी करोगे कब। सो इफ वी ट्रांसलेट इट, इट मीन्स टुमारोज वर्क डू टुडे, टुडेज वर्क डू जस्ट नाउ। इफ द मोमेंट इज लॉस्ट, हाउ विल द वर्क बी डन। इट मीन्स डू द वर्क दैट नीड्स टू बी डन जस्ट नाउ, देर इज नो अदर सुटेबल टाइम देन दिस मोमेंट। सो फॉर स्टूडेंट्स दिस इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट दोहा। सो इट मीन्स दैट whatever you plan to do tomorrow, you do it just now, today itself. So whatever you plan to do today, you do it just now, because you should not go on keeping the things in pending. Immediately you should do. If you decide to study from tomorrow, start studying from today itself. If you are planning to start your study after 4 hours, 5 hours, start studying from just now. And another doha is, it is also quite famous. I see vani boliye, man ka aapa khoye apna, tan sheetal kare, auron ko sukh hoye. So it means soothing, compassionate and loving words breed togetherness, while harsh speech breeds hatred. And we also know that human speech is one of the main ingredients that differentiate mankind from the rest of the animal kingdom. So man is given the power of speech, therefore man should think before speaking, and should speak very suitable words. So the doha crystallizes the power of the spoken word. He says, teaches us to speak in such a manner that keeps us harmonious and composed, thereby making the listener feel a sense of joy in communication. So these are the dohas I introduce you, so that you should understand the dohas of Kabir. This is not part of our poem. The second stanza of the poem is, it is but folly to ask what the caste of a saint may be. The barber has sought God, the washerwoman and the carpenter, even Raidas, that is Rohidas in our area, was a seeker after God. The Rishi Swapcha, he was also a Rishi, a saint. He was tanner by caste. Thus, Hindus and Muslims alike have achieved that end where remains no mark of distinction. So, in the second stanza, the poet once again tells us not to distinguish people based on the caste. He gives here reference of two saints. One is Raidas, that is Rohidas. He is also a mystic poet, and Rohidas belongs to leather working Chambar community. And the Rishi Swapcha, the poet refers all these saints to which Kabir refers, these saints, they try to achieve union with God, and they try to find out the end of life, they try to find out the right way of life so that they can reach to God. In the same way, all the Hindus, including all the castes, they also try to find out the right path to reach to God. Even Muslims also wants to reach to God. And if everybody is trying to reach to the God, everybody is trying to find out the right path of life, then there is no distinction at all. Therefore, all human beings are equal and they should be treated equally. This is what in the second stanza the poet wants to say, Kabir wants to say. And here in this context, and if we think of Indian society, if we want to develop into a strong nation, if we want to develop into a very strong community, a very developed society, what we have to do is we have to construct our nation, our country, unitedly. We should work all together to make our country a strong nation. If we follow the casteism, then our society will be divided, and divided society cannot progress. So therefore the poet wants to tell us that I want to quote a proverb: united we stand, divided we fall. So our society should be a just society. Everybody should get justice. In casteism, what happens? The high caste people, they get all the power in their hands and they do injustice to others. So this is not the right path of life. So if what is the right path of life? So we have to work together, we have to stand together unitedly. And if we stand together unitedly, we'll become a strong nation. So here the proverb is, united we stand, divided we fall. And if you want to construct a very good society, then you should keep away this casteism and should lead life unitedly. All are our brothers and sisters. We have to work together to make our country big and strong and very progressive country. This is what we learn from this poem. Thank you for listening to this video lecture.